AG Labs, my name is Ben. Good morning, hello, welcome to the micro soldering show. Yeah, today it's my 37th birthday, and I'm here at the company just to make a video for you, like I announced yesterday. And yeah, so I hope that we will have a nice video. I get an iPhone X here, which was mailed in, and the customer writes every time when he puts in the SIM card, he had no touch, or it is another shop, when he pushed on the SIM tray, he got no touch. So the device was mailed in and it was docking at the DFU. I just did an update to don't lose the user data. So the update was successful. And now we are at this mode and we can't move the touch in any way. Okay, so it's not possible. If I push, if I press, nothing. So let's see where the problem is. So it started by sporadic touch problems and only no touch if the SIM was getting in. So let's see, it was after an impact, and I think they changed, did they change? No, they didn't change the housing, but the phone had an impact, like. Let's see where the problem is. So we just lose the screws. Getting off all the FPCs. And taking out the board. Okay, now we have a look for the board at under the microscope. And that's what I thought exactly. See that? Here? You see that? It's a disconnection. It's a disconnection of the bottom board to the middle frame, and here you can see the pads are ripped off. You see? Pads are ripped off. So that's the problem why we have no touch. Let me do a photo. Today in the morning I really thought about if I had a heart attack, because I was walking with the dogs. And then it was, I had just pain here in the chest, but I think it comes from my back. But it was hard, really. But I think I worked the whole day here and looking like that and whole day microscope, so can be related to that. Okay, let's check. After that I have the next iPhone X. It has no EMI and just searching, no network, no signal. So in this case here, it will be necessary to do a bottom board swap. And remember, people, I always came here because normally today I do free time. I only come here to give you the video, the Ben's 37th birthday video. So you have something you can look at today. So I need another bottom board which I can use. What about that? That looks okay, I think. Here we have another one.
This looks pretty okay, I think. Yeah, I will try that.
So now we just take off the top board.
I'm tired today in the morning. I was already awake about 5 o'clock. Just a short time, and we can lift up the top layer. And here we are. Done. So, this is what we need. This is what we don't need. Or we need it for some parts, but it just doesn't work at all. Now we just test by using the socket. If that layer works, just need to see for a boot. I don't test touch, because touch will work. After a bottom board swap, I just want to have a look if the bottom board is okay. So I need to have a look for the value. Okay, we are at the DFU again. But that should be normal, because it's the latest revision of iOS, and if we swap the bottom, the board normally goes into the DFU with the latest revision. So just having a look for that. And yeah, that's okay, DFU. So we can just swap the bottom layer. After that, we do a flash retain user data or an update, and the phone will work fine again. So that's the top layer. And we start by preparing the bottom layer. So here, today I will get some new iCloud boards from Rexcom, because mine were out of stock and I ordered yesterday. A lot of people write today, but this was just an email from Adobe. is taking out the clue. One small part loose here. I will fix that later. Another capacitor loose here. Just get it fastened later. And now we just take out the parts. One time, away, second one, hey, come on, just here, okay, and the NFC. Flux is out. Have to fill it off. Okay. Done. Okay, now just fill off my flux. Just a little bit, just for using in this video. And I have to turn on my solder iron. Solder station, sorry. Okay. Just clean the solder. Take it away, all the areas. Okay. Yeah, I think it's just my back. Okay. And now we clean by using some hot air. And a glue cleaning too. Here we need to replace the small part. And here we have a loose capacitor. I will sit that down in a minute. But before I want to clean. Okay. Okay, looks good. Now I just need to get some solder here. done and we can clean. And okay. Okay, that's clean, I think, and now we can just clean around and then we replace the small part and get the other parts to the bottom board. Oh, a lot of people ride, that's really, really nice. Thank you all for congratulations, for the birthday wishes, that's really, really nice. Okay, done. And now we just take the original board. Oh, people, today it's crazy, really. Just take away that thermal paste. And just clean again. We need that small part here. So I don't care about that board here, okay?
How long are we? 25 minutes, such a long time. Yeah, but there are a lot of things to do. So we will have a long video today. So I don't care about the board, okay? And we take out the parts. This we need, and this one we need too. I don't care about the board, so if some parts getting loose or look like this here, it's no problem. But if this happens to you on a working board, you need to get it back like this, okay? So now we need our iCloud lock board or our button board which we use. And we need to take out the baseband EEPROM here. Or we can have a look if we can copy the data by using the JC. Normally I always take it out because it works fast. Yeah, it always says not detected, so it's not a problem to switch that ROM. So this can be kicked out. So we don't need it anymore. Now we can clean again the whole board. And we can do a picture. Okay. And now we need to get the baseband EEPROM from one board to the other board. So here is the new board. I just need to get in some flux here. Like this. And here is the old board. And this is the important ROM we need. So we don't have to lose that. We need that urgently, otherwise no signal at all.
Okay, done. Just a little bit more flux. See, today in the morning, my hand is not calm. Okay, that has been done. And we need to take over the NFC. So I just give some flux on here. And I want to get it out right here. Okay. One second. Okay. And again. And now just soldering it down. Move to your place and done. Ready, prepared. But we need to take the small part here. Don't even forget. Things like this. Okay. Solder the tiny piece down, done, and all is okay. Now we are ready with preparing the new bottom board. Just clean one more time again, and we need to rebore or clean and rebore the baseband CPU and the Wi-Fi IC. Minutes video, okay. Today in the morning I'm really not fast at all. But it was crazy. I was walking with the dogs and I really had pain. It was... I don't know why. Perhaps I just walk to the doctor later, having a look for my back. But I think, because I think it comes from the back, just something which hurts there. Okay. Cleaning the Wi-Fi IC.
And now we can start by reballing, but we don't have toilet paper here. I have to get it. 1 second. Hey. Yeah, what about that? Okay, 1 second. We are. And now we can just start by reballing these chips. One time the Wi-Fi I see. Get the right stencil, should be that here. Yeah, should work. Done. Just reflow. And it's done. And we need to do the baseband IC, the baseband CPU. Wi-Fi already done. Okay, done. Waiting a short time. Cooling down and lifting up. Done. Oh, come here to me. Good, just some more flux. Quick reflow. Done. And now we can take a picture. Wait for me, just doing it like that. And like that. We have already soldered the NFC. So it's just these two which need to add the basement EEPROM we have already soldered. So now it's just soldering down the Wi-Fi IC and the baseband CPU, okay? Should be in that way. Let me check, but I'm pretty sure. No, we are at the X and we need to sit it in that way. Okay. See, one cap is missing here. I will replace that just now. So taking it out here. I just saw it now, so it's better to do it now. Wrong nozzle. So we need to use that one. Come on down, yeah. Here. Okay. Okay, now we can just get it down. And we solder it down with the rest. So all in one.
And you see the capacitor goes into its way. Here the Wi-Fi comes. And here we got the baseband sitting okay. Correctly. Checking for the Wi-Fi. Pretty nice. Okay. And just waiting a short time. After that, reballing the little frame, the top layer board. Cleaning the stencil, getting it down, cleaning the table here, so there is no flux sticking anymore. And getting some paste. Hey, come on in here. Yeah, that's fine. How many people ride today? That's just crazy. But thank you. Thanks to everybody who sends wishes. Wipe. Yep, we should have paste everywhere. And we can start by doing the reball. What about that here? Is there enough paste? Now. Yeah, the rest is okay.
one time around the world. It's the iPhone X. Okay, done. Lifting up. Cleaning one time. Taking off the stencil. Cleaning the bottom. And just give in some flux. Give it a reflow. Done. Wait a short time. Clean one time. Clean the top side for solder. And for paste. Done. Taking away the solder. Six minutes, baby. What the heck? What a long video. But here you can see how much time a bottom layer swap needs. More time than a top layer swap, because it's just more work to do. Top layer, you only have to take out the CPU and the NAND and copy the logic EEPROM data and boom, get it back. But on the bottom layer, you have to do more steps. Taking out more. The NFC, the baseband EEPROM, the baseband CPU, the Wi-Fi module. Reball all of this, replace some small parts. This can happen on top layer swaps too, okay? But normally I'm just faster on doing a top layer swap as on doing a bottom layer swap. And now we clean by using the brush.
now it's just time to resolder that stuff back together. So one picture.
Moin.
And now moin, we resolder that stuff. Oh, selber oder Friseur?
Ja, gut, man sieht's. Flicketeppich, gemäuer. Ich habe mal gewünscht, der Herzinfarkt, ne? Mir ist immer noch komisch. Ich habe beim Lava Stiche da drin gekriegt und dann habe ich kaum noch Luft gekriegt. Ich habe meiner Frau schon die Ohren zugehalten. Hat die gesagt, du hast es nicht mehr, du hast keinen Herzinfarkt, du hast bestimmt nur Wirbel verklemmt. Was meinst du? Mensch, beim Herzinfarkt würde ich noch da sitzen.
Wirklich?
Ja.
Kurzweilig, beziehungsweise langgerissen.
Wie?
Danke. Das heißt, ich gehe doch besser zum Doktor, oder was? Ha?
Ach Gott. Sterb ich daran, danke, Bratz.
Jo, das ist der Notruf.
Danke, danke, danke.
So, now we just get the top layer back to the bottom layer. And after that we should be finished. Ich dachte, ich sterbe am 37. heute Morgen. Naja. Okay, you see that? Now we just put up the heat to 185 degrees. And using our hot air to help. Ich habe mir heute Morgen schon 100 Mikrosolderer gratuliert. Unglaublich. Wahnsinn. Okay, and now we just try to get that board back together. Okay, let's see if it works. Ludo. So, just a little help of the hot air. Come on down, baby. Okay, should be done. Turning off the preheater. And taking the board gently out. Getting it here just for cooling down faster. Get it into the dust absorber just to cool it down faster. Yeah, having a look. Yeah, looks good. Looks flat, great. Just getting the heat away a little bit more, and after that we can just try if that works again. Good morning, David.
Good morning, Mr.
Good. Servus. Jo. And we get the board back here. we just need to get the cables back. Or here was a little dirt I saw before, just a little clue sticker. Okay, done. And just get this back together. Get the stuff back together. We need a working battery. Hope that this FPC is okay. We need a working battery and let's go. Yep, it's 3U, like I said. Can you see something here at 3U? Okay. You see that something happens, but you don't see 3U, I think. You can't see the 3U tools, but yeah, we are just doing restore retaining user data on 3U tools. So I would say boom, back to life again, because we just swapped the whole bottom board and reboot the bottom board and getting all back together and directly detecting at the DFU all like it should be with the new iOS. It's always detected in the DFU mode after swapping the bottom layer. So I would like to show you 3U tools, but why I have a black screen? Why I have a black screen on using here 3U tools at the video? I don't know. I don't know. I have to solve this. Same problem. What about that? No, same problem. Okay, so we just need to wait until this has been done. And after that, the phone will work fine again. So creating file system. I could show to you in that way. Perhaps it works. Video. So, and now I want to see, do you see, 1 second here. Now you should see 3U tools. I hope you can see it on the top, so it just works, creating file system. So, all is nice. But do we really want to wait such a long time, because we already have 1 hour, 7 minutes video. And I think you see that it works. Here, I would tell like that. We close the video now. We have done successfully a bottom board swap for an iPhone X after no touch. After swapping the bottom layer with the new iOS, you always have to do an update on iTunes because it's detected at the DFU mode. We will do so now. And after that, I will just post the repair on Instagram so you can see it there.
And yeah, if you want to learn things like that easily, you can do that at our Bottle Level Repair School Germany or at our one-on-one online training. Just contact me, Bennett@appledoctor.eu. I would be happy to see you at our Facebook group, Smartphone Repair Group Germany. Just join it, but please answer the questions, otherwise we can't accept you. And by the way, buy an ICC Pro, a tool which every technician in the whole world needs. I'm out. We see you with the next video. Boom! Back to life again. Yours, Ben.